Hello everyone. Happy New Year to you. I wish you all a prosperous, healthy, abundant, joyous 2023. May doors open for you and opportunities abound. I would like to take this opportunity to remind you all that my yearly readings for 2023 are available to purchase until the end of January. If you would like to have a personalized yearly projection for 2023, month by month breakdown, to see what energy is coming in for you each month, then make sure you book that reading via my website before the end of January, because it is a limited time offer only. I also have my general yearly readings out if you would like to have a look at those and have a listen to your sign, sun rising or moon sign, and see what's there for you. Lovely Scorpio, welcome to your reading for January 2023. Hope this reading finds you well. I would like to wish you a prosperous, joyous, happy, adventurous 2023. This is a general reading for you, Scorpio. It's a reading for Scorpio sun rising and moon sign. If you would like to have a personalized reading, you can follow the link below to my website and you can book a reading from there that will be specific to you. Thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing, commenting on my channel. I really appreciate your support. If you haven't already subscribed and would like to, make sure you hit the subscribe button and notification bell. That way you will know when I'm posting new videos for you. On with your reading, my lovely Scorpio. What am I? I'm being shown here as your channeled message. I'm being shown, you know, the old vinyls, the old records, and sometimes they were scratched and they'd hit a groove and it would just get stuck. The needle would get stuck. And, you know, for those of you that can remember that, and it just repeats itself. You're stuck in a groove. And there's this repetition. There's this repetition, and it's time to move the needle. It's time to get out of that rut. That same, and that's the, you know, to me, because you're stuck in a groove and you're repeating the same words over and over and over again. It's the same conversations, the same words, the same discussions that are just going around and around and around. And it's time now to change the song. It's time now to get the needle out of that groove and change what you're hearing. Change the song. Stop the repetition. It's time for a change. It's time for renewal. And 2023 is going to give you the opportunity for that renewal. So what is it that is being repeated for you? What conversations are being repeated? What behaviors are being repeated? What cycles are being repeated? What needs to be moved along? What needs to be left behind so that you can have a new song, you can have a new way of being and a new way of thinking? I'm feeling like it's time to get out of that groove. It's time to get out of that feeling of stuckness, that repetition. That allows new energy to come in. That allows change to happen. That allows a release, I'm hearing here for you, my lovely Scorpio, a release of the old. You know, don't hold on to old things. Decide when, you know, okay, that's done. It's lived its purpose. It's done and dusted. Let's let that go. Let's see what else fills that space. You need to clear the old to allow new things to come into that space. When there's that sort of repetitious or conversation that keeps going on and on and on, it's not affecting anyone but you. It's not keeping anyone stuck but you. And so it's coming to that realization. Okay, so January, I feel like you do come to that realization of, well, okay, this is what I want. I want something new. I want to be renewed. I want to have a newness around me, a different way of looking at things, a different attitude, a change in my behaviors or cycles or you know, things that are going on that just keep repeating themselves in my life. Why do they keep repeating themselves? What role, what part are you playing? What is going on with your self-talk, your thought processes? There's something that's going on there. This fell out. I've got the Divine Animal Oracle deck, and I'm this is your totem animal, your spirit animal for the month of January, my lovely Scorpio. And this is the spirit animal energy that comes through. Of course, there'll be other animals, spirit animals, synchronicities that cross your path in January, and that's going to be an individual thing. But this is the overall energy here. And so you've got, you know, number five, which is about change, which is the Wolverine, fierceness. Wolverine, this is fierceness. This is like determination. Determination. Are you determined to change what's going on? Have a determination for this new dawning, this new sunrise, this new way of being. Let's read that, because I also feel like with that there's a sense of what are you needing to fight about? What is that? Let's have a look at what the Wolverine animal energy brings through. Fierceness. Can I hold that up for you? There you go. We should develop a sense of healthy fierceness. Healthy fierceness. Okay, choose your battles. Right now, do not shy away from things that confront you, but choose carefully how you act. You can be fierce, but not angry. Loyalty is important right now. And this is the part of the channeled message that's come through. Releasing that, you're stuck in this groove. This, you know, is it anger? Is it, what energy is it that's coming through? You know, you can release that. You can still have that controlled protectiveness or fierceness, put that into, direct it into the changes you want to bring in around you. So that's interesting channeled message for you. Let's have a look at your Celtic cross. Yeah, because see, there's potential for newness around you. There's potential for this change. I like it. And I'll show you the cards that are coming through for you, but there's great potential here. You know, the hard times, the difficulties are done. The difficulties are done. So what are you going to do with that? This is free, and that's free will. How are you going to use that energy? What are you going to do with it? You're going to stay in that groove and have the same old, or are you going to play a new tune, sing a new song? You've got the Hanging Man. This is growth through suffering. This is growth through, whatever's happened in the past, whatever's gone on in the past. And I feel like I want to say the last 2 years, whatever's gone on there, it's about releasing it. It's about releasing it now. How has it changed you? How has it changed your perception of things? There's growth through that period of time. And so how have you grown? How have you changed? How has your perception changed? It's about maintaining your balance and really looking at things. This is about you. It's not about anybody else, my lovely Scorpio. So how has it changed you? You've also got the beginning of January, you've got the Fool. So the beginning of January, it's an indication that from January 2023, there's potential here for a new start. There's potential here for a turning point. There's potential here for something new to come through. What is that for you? Where do you want to go? How do you want to be? What do you want to create? This is a blank canvas for you. Beginning of January, you have a blank canvas, and I feel very much that it's on you. It's your choices. It's your free will. What do you want to do with this potential, my lovely Scorpio? What are you going to do? This is the first card in the tarot deck. So this is the beginning of a new journey that's coming up for you, which is very exciting. This is the new song that's being sung. You've also got the Two of Wands. So there's going to be choices and decisions here for you to make. These choices and decisions are going to come up very quickly for you. There's crossing new thresholds. Doesn't matter which one you choose. They're both going to bring in change and positivity. So what choices are you going to make? What decisions are you going to make? Are you going to move forward? Are you going to walk through that threshold? Are you going to stay behind? This is about something you feel passionate about. This is about something that brings excitement and joy to you. This is about something that brings opportunities, synchronicities around you. What's the boredom around you, Scorpio? Some of you, this might be for some of you, but I feel like there's a sense of boredom. There's a sense of some space that needs to be filled. How are you going to fill it? What are your interests? What are you going to do? You're going to also feel in January that you feel like, oh, I need some time out. Just sort of go to the beach, go for a swim, go for walks, meditate, stay in bed and read a book. Depending on the weather that's going on around you at the time, if you're in the northern hemisphere, it's pretty cold, it's, you know, snowy. If you're in the southern hemisphere or in somewhere sunny, you know, you might go for walks, go to the beach, but this, you're going to feel like, I need to withdraw, I need to meditate, I need some time out to process, to think clearly. And it's when you remove yourself from a situation that you can look at it from a distance and you can see things more clearly. Things are clarified for you rather than having the distractions and other people's opinions and things going on in your life. Having that tranquility and space is what you're going to really desire for this new change and choices that are coming up for you. You've also got the Four of Coins, and it's about really playing your cards close to your chest. Let's keep your ideas to yourself for a bit. Let's process those. What do you want in your reality? What are you saving for? What do you want to invest in? This is being protective of your resources, being protective of you, being protective of your emotions, being protective of who you are and the changes you want to bring in. You might still be processing them and not quite ready to talk about them or share them with others. And so until you're ready to share them with others, you keep things to yourself. What have we got? Oh, you see, you've got the Fool again. This is Fool energy. This is a new start. This is having the courage to move forward, having the courage to even if you don't know what you're moving to, bring in changes or leave the past behind. This is a real time of transition for you. It's a time of closing the door on the past, closing the door on 2022 and moving into 2023. This is a new time for you. This is a time for you to invent yourself, to create who you want to be. Because there's making choices. And it's interesting because these cards came out and they're exactly the same cards as your first two cards. They're exactly the same, different decks, but exactly the same. So that message is really being reinforced for you. You've got the Fool energy, which leads to making choices and decisions, which I like. What are you going to decide? What decisions and choices are you going to make? Because it's going to lead to crossing a threshold, moving into a new reality, which is going to be very successful for you. It's going to be very spontaneous. It's going to be busy. There's celebrations coming up around you as well in January, I want to say. There's some sort of celebrations that week three of January. But there's this crossing of a threshold. There's a new start, a new beginning, an opportunity to think differently, to have different self-talk. But there's something that you're going to do that is successful. And then it's about being patient. It's about setting your goals, setting your dreams, and then being patient and letting that goodness unfold for you. When the timing is right, the tree will bear fruit. The opportunities will come to you. There is success around you as well. I feel like you're going to win something, or you're going to have a windfall, or something's coming in your direction. There's some sort of shift or change in your environment that's coming through for you in January as well. And it can be very, very positive if you choose to change with it. So it's all really up to you. There is just this free will. You're doing a lot of thinking, of processing, goal setting. There's a new way, thinking about how can I communicate differently? How can I think differently? How can I work differently? What am I learning here? What goals am I setting? You're giving something an incredible amount of thought. There's absolutely nothing to fear, because any changes that you bring in are going to have extremely positive results, extremely positive consequences. There's anything you put in place, any new business you want to start, any promotion, change of job, any changes you want to bring into your home environment, your family environment, very, very positive results. They're going to be very fruitful. There's going to be a lot of positivity around it. Absolutely. By week 3 and 4 of January, set whatever goals you want to set. A world of opportunity here. There's an opportunity of releasing a whole lot of stuff, releasing the old to bring in the new. Now you can do that, or the universe will come in and do it for you, but it's much better if you do it as well. There's a cleansing of what no longer serves you, what do you no longer need, what attitudes, behaviors, thought patterns, self-talk, people in, work, what is it that you want to release? It's going to come through like a bolt of lightning, this realization to you. You've also got the King of Wands here. This is male or female, Libra, Gemini, Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius person that's around you. Male or female, sun rising, moon sign. There's some sort of confusion around them. There's some sort of confusion or something that they're needing clarified. So they're going to, you might have a lot to do with them or talk to them. There's something that needs to be clarified. There's confusion around this person. I don't know whether you can help them or not. Interesting. Let's see what unfolds. For some of you, this is you finding that fire in your belly, that interest, that passion, that hobby, that new job. You're in control. So once you clear the old, there's this new strength that comes through for you. There's this new strength of new work. New way of being, new way of seeing things, travel, a whole lot of change coming in. How big do you want this change to be, my lovely Scorpio? It's totally up to you. It's totally up to you how much change comes in for you and to what degree and what intensity, if at all. Maybe you want to stay in playing that old song, but I wouldn't. I'd move on. I'd play a new song, new record, new CD, new whatever. And have it moving rather than being stuck, hearing that same old, same old, same old, same old. Too much. Let's bring in some change. So I've got the Divine Abundance deck that I'm drawing from, and I've got two cards came out for you. You've got ease. It's easy for me to receive. It's easy for me to receive. It's easy for me to receive. And that's you bringing in the change. You got, the Fool and the Two of Wands twice. So decisions and newness coming in. Receive what's there, what's coming for you. And divine love. When you offer everything to the divine with detachment, you begin a love affair with spirit. Release. This is about release. Release it up. Let it go. It's holding you back. Very telling. Exciting. It's a month filled with great potential, great excitement. How much of it are you going to fall into? How much are you going to utilize that energy? Because it's there for you. My lovely Scorpio, love, light, and many blessings to you. If you would like to book a private reading with me, you can follow the link below to my website and book that reading from there. That will be specific to you. Also, a reminder that my yearly readings are available till the end of January if you would like to book a personalized yearly reading that's specific to you. So don't miss out if that's what you're desiring to do. Love, light, and many blessings to you.